Hey guys, today we're talking about cognitive biases. A cognitive bias is something that you can use in your artillery of design to help you create better websites. If you can use these five psychological tricks that I'm about to show you in your website design, you can dramatically improve the efficiency of your website and also just generally the overall look and feel of the design. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Arnell Ross and I like to do videos about design. Subscribe to watch more videos like this and let's just jump right into the video. So there's so many types of cognitive biases in web design that you don't even know about, but if you learn a few of them, you can really learn to just elevate the way that you work and really improve the way your websites look and feel. Now, the first one we're gonna take a look at is called the Von Restroff effect. I've always wondered why some websites do this, and now that I know about these certain effects, I'm more aware of it and I can kind of start to decide to do it on my own websites. The way that it works is using something different, something completely unique that not a lot of websites have. A prime example of this is a website called Kappen.com. They use a bunch of different animations and transitions to kind of separate themselves from the pack. The way that they create their website is just really different to anything I've seen before. They have certain animations and maybe it runs a little bit slow just because my computer's a bit old. But you have all of these different animations and styles of design that you don't really see anywhere else. And that can really make you remember the website and kind of stand out in this wave of websites that exist in the world, especially digital marketing agencies. Now, although it's really great to kind of want to make your website stand out from the crowd and try to make it stand out to other people that view it, you have to remember that people can only focus on a few things at a time. Just as humans, we can only focus on a couple things at a time. Now, this is called cognitive load, and there's a few examples of websites that use this really, really well. So one of them is called Apple. Now, on Apple's website, you have only a few things are being shown at the time. You can only see a couple things at a time. And this is done specifically so you have that hierarchy of product name and then a hero image for each product or for each section. And what that allows is for the user or the viewer to only see what you essentially want them to see. They can only focus on a few things at a time. Another example of this is firmpipe.com. They do metal fences and security gates, and they kind of guide you through the website, so you can only see a few things at a time. Just like the Apple website, this is a pretty similar way of looking at it. And this kind of perfectly leads us on to our next cognitive bias, because one way of getting that user's attention is through an anchoring bias. So it's kind of what you're seeing here. It's one image or one thing just taking over the screen and making sure that you are looking right at that. And we can see that through 5secondcontent.com. So here in the hero, we see that there's this really impactful hero animation. And this is done to put a lot more impact on what you're seeing. This is the only thing that's on your screen, and that's obviously what you should focus on. And there's nothing else competing for your attention. And that's what they want. They want you to read that it takes 7 seconds to make an impression. We do it in 5. So now I'm intrigued to know more about what they do. Maybe they do commercials in 5 seconds, or their TikTok agency, whatever it is. Now I'm intrigued to know more because they took my attention and they kind of made me focus and made me listen to what they have to say. Now, one thing about all these cognitive functions that we can see is that a lot of websites kind of multiply them. So they use multiple cognitive biases to kind of build a really well-rounded website. So they use a lot of different psychological tricks that you can too in your own website, and they do it to kind of keep that user scrolling and to keep that user on their webpage, and in the end try to get them to buy something or to message them or to contact them, whatever the end goal is or the CTR is. This is all done specifically to kind of guide the end user. And sometimes you can add extra bits of layer here and there to kind of guide the user to where you want them to go. This is a cognitive bias called priming, and the website Wikrit here does this really well. We can see this being used very subtly by these kind of hovering balls, or these animations of the cards going up and the banking reimagined, and everything is scrolling up. And what that does is it makes you want to actually have to scroll and keep going and keep going and looking at their animations, and wow, they're so well done, and this is so cool. And these are all tiny signals that get you to actually go and scroll and look at what they have to say and actually read about their message and about their banking stuff and whatever it is that they're selling. Now, if you notice, they're also using the bias of cognitive loading. So only a few things are being shown to you at a time. So they only want you to see what they want you to see. And then at the end, when you get to the actual buying part of the website, or they kind of guided you to the end and you're there already, and all you have to do is click buy, there are a few things that websites do to kind of help you get there, and that's called nudging. We can see this in Bellroy's actual product page, and this is something that I'm sure you've seen in all websites like Amazon and Shopify and all that, but it's this little thing here called free express shipping. These little signals kind of help you to key your eye to these specific colors and really pay attention to what they have to say. So right now, the first thing that I'm gonna read here is obviously the hierarchy, so the Folio, the 145, but then I'll read free express shipping. So I'll automatically assimilate that with free express shipping. This product now has free express shipping in my head, and that's the only thing that I'm reading from here on out. And so once you combine all of these ideas, you kind of have this well-rounded website that allows you to kind of guide the end user to wherever you want them to go, because you have the power or that these kind of hacks or these tricks to kind of help them through that mission. If you guys want to check out 5 more amazing websites that I review, then check out the video on screen right now, because I go over them right there. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you on the next one.